exercise 14 multi-language and translations. So the goal is to translate text, not all, but some text, in another language. We will translate in Italian, of course, and let the user to select the current language runtime. So the first step is to set or select what text can be translated, because normally the text are not or cannot be translated. The way to select the text as translatable is, regarding the parameters, is to use as value type the option TR string, translatable string. We use this 2-3 exercises ago. Regarding the text, you have to add a prefix T, open curly bracket, and a suffix, close curly bracket. So we can set this as a text that we can translate. So we can add the prefix T, open curly bracket, and close. Also this one, T, open, and close, set point, we can leave not translatable, we can change this so we can see the difference. T, open, and close. The last in status, T, open, and close. So this and also the my children text can be translated, while set point no, because it hasn't a prefix. Also this can be translated, the description, because you see it has the prefix. Well, next step we have to add a language. So in the languages, right click, add translation. You can select Italian, also description, Italiano. Here we can select a file for the translation, so it is possible to export and import all the text, more or less like in OneTool C Suite. For now, we don't use it, but we will see later. Okay, save. Now, how to translate? We have to double click the language here. We can update the list of translation. Here is, there are 156 new text. So we can translate all this text. So let's search for the My Chiller. Okay, if you scroll this list, it's very difficult. We can use the filter. Here is, so original text is this, the translation. We can simply change this new chiller C web. We can translate also inlet temperature. Temperatura ingresso. Also this one. Temperatura in, come like ingresso, sorry. And differential, let's go back. Differenziale, and the last stato, unit status, here is stato unità. Well, I have translated the most important text here, so save. We can also see how to export. We can save the text into a file, then translate, and then import back. So we will not see this, it's quite intuitive. So next step is to let the user to select the current language. For this we can use two object display. They are here in the CARL special, is this one or this one. Not mandatory to use both of them, it's just one of the two. The difference is that with this you don't see the language, you see the language only when you click the icon, while in this case you always see the current language. It is easier to test rather than explain it. So this is all. Save, distribute. Now the issue of the cache becomes more heavy because we have to refresh, reload frame and then refresh each language. So probably this is the right time to switch from Chrome and start to use Edge. Edge is not affected by the issue of the cache because it doesn't use the cache. Here is English, so you can change to Italiano. So mio chiller, temperatura ingresso, differenziale, stato unità. Okay. Ah, I forgot to when I have added this to change the description. Okay, doesn't matter. You see that here you always see the current language, while with this the list appears only when you click English and back to my chiller, inlet temperature, differential, inlet status, and so on. Another way to run a given language is to indicate it here in the address bar. We can add a question mark language equal and the ID of the language, for example IT for Italian. And there is mio chiller or EN for English. Here is my chiller. Okay, this is just another option. So, quick review. So, text can be translated. To be able to translate a text, we have to set the parameter as a TR string, translatable text, or add a prefix and a suffix to the fixed text. After that, right-click language, add a language, you can select the ID and a description, and then double-click the language in the Solution Explorer, update translation, and using the search you can translate the text. You can also export-import all the text, so export, translate, import. After that you can use these two widgets, the button display language or the button switch language, to change the language. Another way to change the language is indicate the current language in the address bar here. Well, that's all.